The Subcommittee on Aquaculture is a unique global forum where aquaculture-related matters are debated and strategic plans developed at the highest level by representatives of countries and their respective aquaculture authorities from all over the world. Your presence confirms the continuing importance of aquaculture and the significance of this subcommittee for your countries.
One of the main things we discussed at the COFI subcommittee on aquaculture was the role that aquaculture can play in food security and nutrition, and the contribution that aquaculture can make to the sustainable development goals.
En Guinée, l'emploi des jeunes pour nous aujourd'hui est considéré être comme étant le fondement de la lutte contre l'insécurité alimentaire et la lutte contre l'immigration. Parce que l'immigration, quand on prend sa cause fondamentale, c'est la pauvreté. Et la pauvreté est un élément de l'insécurité alimentaire. Et nous avons privilégié l'installation des jeunes pour alors, le développement de cette activité à travers des écoles professionnelles au sein desquelles nous commençons à intégrer l'enseignement de la pisciculture.
And talking about food security, Filipinos consume nowadays 36 kilos of fish annually. And aquaculture contributes around 25 to 30% of that. Aquaculture is has a many pronged function in our society. Food, we have mentioned about that, employment, and foreign trade as well.
Mi país se caracteriza porque la mayoría de los jóvenes de las zonas rurales van a otros países o van a la ciudad. Entonces, con la producción acuícola se genera mano de obra y con eso va, se produce que mejore en forma integral la calidad de vida de la población nacional.
Regarding the young people and also they have no, sometimes they're dealing with the no employment in the rural areas. It's very interesting for them to get engaged. And in that sense, we try to bring the training.
The COFI Subcommittee on Aquaculture organized a side event on antimicrobial resistance and aquaculture. This is an emerging and timely subject that needs to be addressed. So the side event discussed ways on how to move this forward because aquaculture is being challenged by the imprudent use of antimicrobials.
With respect to AMR in animal products, most animal producers are aware of it, and so is the general public. However, when it comes to fish, most cannot relate AMR and fish because aquaculture is an emerging industry.
Compared to other countries, I think Singapore has the advantage of having both the fishery sector, the livestock sector, and the food safety sector under the same agency. And by taking the lead country, we could help coordinate efforts across these sectors.
One of the main pillars of the new action plan that has just been adopted in June this year is to shape our global agenda, meaning that we intend to reinforce cooperation with other international partners, international organizations and third countries.
At these COFI aquaculture sessions, we brought participants from the SIDS, coming from the Pacific, from the Caribbean and from Africa, in order to discuss with them about the challenge in implementing blue growth and developing aquaculture in their nations.
One of the issues is limited resources when it comes to human resources, technical capacity, the need for training, the issue of climate change, which is, you know, quite evident, that is really impacting the natural resource base.
Donc effectivement, au niveau de l'Atlantique, on n'est que deux. São Tomé, Príncipe et l'île de Cap Vert. Donc l'échange avec les autres du Pacifique, la Méditerranée et même l'océan Indien, je crois que c'est vraiment une opportunité d'échanger des expériences.
Although we're very different countries, the issues we face are pretty similar to each other. So with respect to us being a small island sort of dispersed in the ocean, issues of transportation and costs involved with doing any economic activity really is a lot higher than the rest of the countries.
You know, Nauru depends so much on the fisheries and marine resources, you can basically say that, you know, 90% of the people depend on fish, you know, for protein. There is a big demand, you know, there is a lack of, you know, supply. So I think aquaculture will play a big role in trying to make the most out of, you know, getting more in terms of supply for the local people.
We are extremely pleased from FAO side that we have had record attendance of countries here, record attendance in terms of numbers, that we have Norway host the next session of the subcommittee in 2019. And not only that, we already have the expression of interest from the government of Mexico for the second next session in 2021. So we are extremely pleased with this development and with the increased interest from member countries also to host the subcommittee, because they see this as an important opportunity to raise the flag of aquaculture.